Hi, my name is Jeremy Osbern, and I'm here to review the Stanley Kubrick film from 1971, A Clockwork Orange. As the film opens, we're introduced to Alex and his gang of juvenile delinquents in a bar that serves milk laced with drugs as they get ready to inflict pain on the society around them.
Now tell me what you had in mind, Georgie boy.
From the get-go, we find ourselves in a dark and twisted future.
Let's get it, boys!
And everyone presented to us is engaged in evil acts in one form or another. Alex is chief among them, killing and torturing people that cross his path in acts of pure hedonism. But we're also presented Alex as a character that could be something different if society had presented him with the option. He loves beauty and Beethoven and language, and these are the things that make him human and relatable, even though his acts are those of a monster.
Singing in the rain, just singing in the rain.
Eventually, his deeds catch up with him, and the state attempts to rehabilitate him by stripping him of violence, but inadvertently strips him of his love of beauty and Beethoven as well. Alex then wanders the ruins of this dystopian landscape, the shell of a man he once was, with the acts of his past catching up to him, torturing him, and leaving him unable to exist in the world. In the novel, Alex then moves into a new enlightened state on his own, growing a new humanity and leaving his lawless, violent ways behind. In the movie, produced against a backdrop of war, protests, and a corrupt Nixon administration, worldwide cynicism was at an all-time high, and Kubrick's film ends with Alex being cured all right, with a return to endless circle of violence.
I was cured all right.
I watched this film in the eighth grade, and it's the movie that made me want to become a filmmaker. Up until this point, I viewed movies as something to watch while eating popcorn and then forget about it, but with this film, and being presented with its big ideas about society, corruption, and retribution, I realized that film can be something else entirely. It means to make people think about life in a new way, to affect people, and to even bring about change. Recently, I filmed a movie called The Big Ugly, which starred Ron Perlman, Vinnie Jones, and Malcolm McDowell. And getting to work with Malcolm, the man who starred in the movie that made me become a filmmaker, was truly a dream come true. This movie had a lot to say about society in the 1960s and 70s, and it is definitely worth a revisit today. Like us, the characters in Clockwork Orange are bombarded with a constant barrage of violent images, and the people who engage in these acts,
if it isn't little Alex,
like the members of Alex's own gang, are then welcomed into a society which allows them to perpetuate violence in an unending cycle. And how can we as a society break free of this cycle of violence? These are the questions we're still asking today. And hopefully with enough people on the streets working for change, we can find a solution and not just end up as more droogs at the Krovimal bar.